la cacerola y dijo:
¡Qué hambre tengo! Te voy a comer enterito.
Así que el monstruo abrió mucho la boca y ¡zasca! Se zampó al sastrecillo. Y el niño cayó y cayó en una caverna oscura y llena de porquería.
¿Ya está?
Es que no se me ocurre nada más.
Bueno, mañana se te ocurrirá. ¿Vamos a la cama?
Pero mamá, no tengo sueño y aún no lo he acabado.
Ya, cariño, pero tu madre está muy cansada porque ha trabajado todo el día y necesita dormir. Venga, te llevo. Dios mío, cuánto pesa ya. Pues habrá que terminar el cuento, ¿no? A ver, ¿cómo te puedo ayudar? Déjame que piense. ¿Te acuerdas que el sastre le había regalado a su hijo unas tijeritas?
Sí.
Pues de pronto se acordó que las llevaba encima. Las sacó y empezó a cortar. Chac, 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 chac. Y el monstruo gritaba: ¡Ay! ¿Quién me está cortando? El sastrecito. Chac, chac, chac.
¡Ya sé, ya sé! ¡Ya sé! El niño salió y se hizo un abrigo con la piel del monstruo. Y así ya no le podrían hacer daño a la flecha. ¿Lo voy a acabar ahora?
No, no. Ahora vas a dormir, que luego no hay quien te levante.
Pues mamá...
Bueno, José, bueno. Duérmete ahora y mañana temprano sacamos al sastre de la tripa del monstruo.
No cierres. Miedo está afuera. Y a lo mejor querría entrar.
Y nada de soñar con monstruos, ¿eh? o solo ha sido una pesadilla? ¿Eh? Solo ha sido una pesadilla. Tranquilo, ya pasó. Ya pasó.
¿Y si vuelve?
Si vuelve, cierra los ojos y cuentas hasta 5. Cuando los abras, ya verás cómo ha desaparecido.
I'm gonna call her. It's driving me crazy, man. I can't stop thinking about her.
Oh, I'm sure Carol will be very happy about that.
Fuck off. You're not an angel. Don't tell me you never thought about it.
Listen, mate, I'm very happy with what I've got.
I mean, what could be so wrong with a bit of no questions asked harmless fun with a filthy stranger to spice up your love life? Just as long as Carol didn't find out.
And if she does?
I'd deny it. Wouldn't you?
Listen, mate, if I were you, I'd just get it out of the way and tell her everything now.
No. Fuck off. Come on.
Keep an eye on Frank. I have to call my daughter.
Yeah, she does. She needs me very much. But my brother's dead, so... Yeah.
Send her my love.
I will. That's nice of you. Thank you. Yeah, my gosh. She's gorgeous. Too explicit.
Hey, Dad. Where are you?
Sorry, sweetheart. I'm still at work. I'm going to be another hour.
That's too bad. Grandma made me her famous cake.
Yeah, don't tell me. Chocolate, jam in the middle, and fake cream on top. Is Mum there? Can I talk to her?
Sure. Dad wants to talk to you.
Hi, baby. Yeah. Okay.
So glad to see you.
No, we'll be right.
Where's Winnie going?
Yeah. Where are you going? What have you found?
Hollowface woke up because someone called his name. After many, many years, he was free. He wasn't young or old or ugly or handsome. He had no shape. He didn't even have a face. He remembered a boy with a face that looked like him. Hollowface had to find the boy. He had to find his face. Until one night, Hollowface finally found a face to steal. It was a little boy, staring out of a window. Hollowface wanted the boy's face more than anything else in the world. Without the face, he had nothing. So he devised a plan. First, he'd separate the boy from his parents. Then he'd take him back to his lair. He'd rip off his face and wear it himself. That way, everybody would love him. The next night, Hollowface dressed up as a man and went back to the boy's house. He ran up the wall quickly. He slipped through an open window. He found the boy's room and slipped inside. The boy was sleeping. Hollowface moved closer and closer and closer.
Continue, Mia.
That's all I have.
You haven't finished it?
I didn't know how to.
It's not bad. You've hooked your audience and left us with a cliffhanger. Try to finish it for next week. Well, we're all looking forward to finding out what happens next, aren't we?
See you later. Oh, what time was the party again?
6. Don't forget.
Okay, bye.
See ya.
Birthday girl.
Daddy.
Happy birthday.
It's a teddy bear.
We got you something else, Steve.
It's nearly 50 years old.
An old teddy bear. Cool. I love it, Dad. Really.
So, how old are you again? 9? 10?
Dad.
4? Okay, guys, it's time.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Hollowface woke up because someone called his name. After many, many years, he was free. When Hollowface came out of his lair, the people looked right through him. It was like he was invisible. He saw people in the street, talking and kissing, and knew that without a face, no one could love him. Hollowface kept hunting for a boy to steal his face. He looked everywhere, in every window of every house, until one night, he found a house with a child inside, and an open window. He crept through the rooms and down the corridor where he saw a girl who was still awake. So he crept closer and closer. And he forgot all about hunting for the boy. Now Hollowface wanted the girl's face more than anything else in the world. So he devised a plan. He would hide in the dark corner of her room and wait for her to go to sleep. And then he would...
You don't need it.
I do.
That's pathetic.
Mia. Mia, go to your room.
What is it? What's the matter, sweetheart?
Mia, you have school tomorrow. Go. John.
Come on, it's her birthday. Okay, birthday girl.
Can't sleep.
Too much Coca-Cola.
It's not that.
No? What is it then? Come on, let's get you into bed. Oh, I can see you love my present.
Dad, I'm 12 years old.
Do you hear that? Sorry, mate, I think you should have stayed in the shop. Looks like she's just a little bit too grown up for you. Oh, yeah, she's wearing lipstick and everything. Come on, you should try to sleep.
I love you, Dad.
I love you, too.
Desde el comienzo, él fue homicida. Y no tiene nada que ver con la verdad. Porque no hay verdad en él. Si vosotros permanecéis en mi palabra, seréis verdaderamente mis discípulos. Y conoceréis la verdad. Y la verdad os hará libres.
Tienes que decir Ave María Purísima.
Ave María Purísima.
Sin pecado concebida. He ¿Cuándo fue la última vez que te confesaste?
No sé. No me acuerdo.
No pasa nada. Adelante, cuéntame. No tienes que avergonzarte. El Señor es bueno y siempre nos perdona. Venga, mujer. Venga, mujer. No puede ser tan terrible.
Keep going. Sorry, mate.
Come on, you. Concentrate. You gotta get all that done by today.
Here, boss.
Dad.
Jesus. Scared the life out of me. You okay, sweetheart? What's the matter?
I had a nightmare.
What was it about? Come here. Come on. Go back to bed. You've got school tomorrow.
What if the nightmare comes back?
Come on.
Dad, where are we going?
Come on, it's fine. Why are you standing out there? Come on.
What are you doing?
Yes, got it. Do you remember this?
The anti-nightmare book.
Dad, this is ridiculous.
Come on. Come and sit down.
I haven't read this in ages.
Come on. Now. Which one shall we read?
No.
This one? Okay. So, if a big red devil with big teeth and claws comes to you and tries to squeeze you in its jaws, just light it up and say...
Dad.
Oh.
You two grown up...
And you'll see it's just a shadow, and you can see it through. See, monsters are cowards. If you stand up to them, they run away.
Not this one. This one's different.
They're all the same, all cowards. And you know they'd never dare come into this house if they know I'm here.
But he's already inside.
What do you mean? Where?
I don't know. I think he spies on me when I'm asleep. I know he's there.
Right. Now, to kill a monster, you have to enter their story. See, they think you're gonna run away. But if you enter their story, they're screwed. So, now, there's something missing. Ah, perfecto. Wow, there he is. There's our monster. So, you think you're scary, huh? Now listen, mate. It's the end of the road. We've had enough. You cannot keep bothering my daughter at night. Okay, stand back.
Mia, go to your room.
It's all right. We were just playing.
What do you mean, playing? You could have burned the house down.
She had a nightmare. We were just getting rid of it.
What do you mean, getting rid of it? What do you mean? What is this?
Sue, it was a game.
Throw this thing away before it stinks up the whole house. Pase, por favor. Juan. Juan. El padre Antonio ha venido a verte.
No parece tener fiebre.
Hola, Juan.
Me llamo Antonio. ¿Te acuerdas de mí? Mira, te he traído tu muñeco. Lo dejo aquí, ¿vale?
¿Tu madre me ha dicho que no duermes bien?
Vete.
¿Por qué dices eso? No tienes que avergonzarte. Yo también tenía pesadillas cuando era como tú.
Son pesadillas.
¿Qué te da miedo? ¿Las brujas? No existen. Y lo del coco también es mentira. A mí siempre me lo contaban para que me acabara la comida. Solo es un cuento. Y no hay que tener miedo de los cuentos. Vamos a hacer una cosa. Tú me dices qué es lo que te asusta a ti. Y yo te cuento. Todos los días hablo con un amigo al que no se puede ver. Me da miedo que mi amigo no me conteste. Que le hable y no me diga nada. Ahora te toca a ti, Juan. ¿Qué te da miedo?
Mia, what's the matter? What is it? What's wrong? Tell me. There's nobody here, it's just you and me. Are you okay?
What's going on?
There's a fucking man in the room!
for business.
I think he must have come in through the window. I chased after him, but he'd gone.
Did you see his face? Could you give us a description?
It was dark. He had a hood on.
That's a forensics, George. Now, once an intruder's been seen, he very rarely comes back. We'll get him. Don't worry, Mr. Farrell.
Thank you. He said not to worry. He said he definitely won't come back. It's okay. Sit down here, lovely. Has she said anything?
What do you want to say? She's terrified.
Are you okay? What is this, sweetheart? Talk to me. Mia. Talk to me. Sweetheart, tell me what's wrong. Mia. Sweetheart, what is it?
¿Todo bien?
No me extraña que el padre haya salido huyendo.
¿Se lo ha contado ella?
No, qué va. Solo habla de presencias y que el niño tiene algo dentro. Están los dos como un cencerro, el niño y la madre, como para no salir huyendo.
Pues le ha contado más a usted que a mí.
Es que tú no sabes tratar a las mujeres.
¿Y les va a ayudar?
¿Qué quieres que haga?
No sé. Hacerles pensar que Se lo ha sacado.
¿Sacarles el qué? Estamos hablando de una cosa muy seria, ¿eh?
No tenemos que hacerlo por la vía oficial. Sería como un placebo.
Entonces, no se puede hacer un rito tan serio para que a una histérica se le pase el nervio. Por muy guapa que sea. Que no se juega con esas cosas, coño. Déjalos en paz, anda. Esto es trabajo para psiquiatras. No para nosotros.
And then he leapt from your window.
Oh, Mia, I'm sorry. What a terrible thing to go through. It must be terrifying. And you haven't been able to speak ever since? Or you haven't wanted to? Things, and it's important to know. You can't. You know, it's all right to be afraid. I get scared too sometimes. Everyone does. Please come with me. As there's nothing physically preventing your daughter from speaking, her silence is an acute emotional response to the severe shock she experienced.
So what can we do?
Well, we have to be patient.
Should she keep going to school?
Oh, yes, absolutely. You don't want to disrupt her routine, but I will need to see Mia every day.
Every day?
Mr. Farrow, I'm sure you want to avoid Mia reliving the experience through flashbacks or recurrent nightmares. We want to facilitate a successful emotional processing of the trauma through basic counseling. During the sessions, Mia will confront her fears. I found the method to be extremely effective.
Holoface did not give up. He would wait for the right moment to rip off the girl's face. Holoface crept closer and closer and closer.
You haven't got one that's a bit quieter.
Quieter? You wouldn't have a chihuahua as a guard dog, would you? This is a Rottweiler. It's an excellent choice. Complete security package. No more worries. Right, how about that?
I made you something to eat.
You're doing your homework.
Listen, Mia, you don't have to do it if you don't want to. Want to, okay. Come here. Come here.
Well, you can only access the images on the central website with a password. It's very secure. Yes, I might. Yep. I need to enter a password for a customer. Name John Farrow. Yep. 1967.
Hola, Juan. ¿Cómo estás? ¿Te acuerdas de mí?
Holoface crept closer and closer. The girl knew that Holoface was there. She could feel him watching her. She wanted to scream for help, but when she opened her mouth, she couldn't make a sound. Her parents couldn't keep her safe because Holoface was already inside. He had made a new lair, right in her room, in a dark corner everyone had forgotten about. His new lair was big enough for both of them. Holoface would drag the girl into his lair and keep her there in the dark. Imprison her, away from her parents, forever. Then she wouldn't need her face ever again. He started calling her to his lair. She felt his claws reaching out to her.
We're going to run some allergy tests. Anaphylactic shock is a severe hypersensitivity body reaction, but I don't want you to worry, Mrs. Farrow. We will find what triggered it. In the meantime, I'm going to prescribe some intravenous adrenaline and sedatives in case of emergency. If she loses consciousness and the ambulance takes too long, you can inject it yourself. It takes only a couple of seconds to take effect. I'll have a nurse show you how it works.
Thank you.
I'll go get a nurse.
Could you give us a description?
I mean, it looked really weird. It's like it's deformed.
Deformed? Oh, but it's a good job he installed those security cameras. I'll have one of my men check the coverage. And we'll need your password.
Yeah, of course. Sorry, would you excuse me? Hey. How is she?
She's all right, she's all right. It's Dave. Please take me, he's been calling the whole time.
Hello?
Sorry, Mrs. Farrow. Can you tell me what happened tonight?
I'm calling because your mother asked me to. Shh. Your mother wants to speak.
Don't worry, everything's fine. I'm taking care of the situation.
She worries about Mia. How is she, John?
I didn't see him. I just...
John?
Dave, I can't talk right now. Sorry, I've got to go.
Dave, how are they?
They'll be fine.
Sentaos.
Vamos a rezar juntos. Yo voy a decir una oración. Y vosotros la repetís. ¿De acuerdo?
Mamá dice que vas a hacer que Carahueca se vaya.
Eso es. Jesús va a venir, va a coger a Carahueca y lo va a lanzar a un agujero muy profundo del que no podrá salir.
Pero Carahueca puede volar.
Juan, calla y obedece al padre.
Santiguaos. Dame tu mano. Tú, Señor, eres mi refugio. Él te librará de la red del cazador y de la peste perniciosa. Repite.
Tú eres, Señor, mi refugio. Él te librará de la red del cazador y de la peste.
De la peste perniciosa.
De la peste perniciosa.
No temerás los terrores de la noche ni la flecha que vuela de día. Juan, por favor.
No quiero.
No pasa nada. Vamos a hacer otra cosa. Yo rezo y tú lo repites sin hablar, solo para ti. Cierra los ojos. No temerás los terrores de la noche ni la flecha que vuela de día. No puedo. No puedo hacerlo. No puedo expulsarlo si no sé quién es. Y tú sabes quién es, ¿verdad?
No tiene cara. Su cara está escondida. Yo no puedo verla.
No puedes verla porque lleva una capucha, ¿verdad? Cierra los ojos. Trata de imaginártelo. Quítasela. Quítale la capucha.
Padre, ya basta.
Muy bien, Juan. Bien. ¿Dónde está? Aquí no hay nada.
Se ha ido.
Es solo una estatua. Luisa.
No puede ayudarnos. Usted no puede hacer nada.
Es solo una estatua. Os lo habéis imaginado todo. Luisa. Luisa. Dime lo que has visto.
Mamá, ¿dónde vamos?
No sé, lejos. Venga, Juan, ayúdame. Cierra tu maleta.
¿Crees que nos perseguirá?
No, nadie va a seguirnos porque nos vamos muy lejos. ¿Entiendes?
Pero tú también lo viste, ¿verdad?
Juan, yo no he visto nada. ¿Me oyes?
Is everything okay? Sue, where's Mia? Is she okay?
She's here, John. She'll be fine.
Hello, John.
What is this?
Please, John, take a seat. Mia knows that she has the full love and support of both her parents, especially you, John. You have a very special bond with her.
I should hope so, my father.
Mm. Susanna tells me that you haven't slept well since your incident at work.
I think we've all had trouble sleeping ever since a man started appearing in my daughter's bedroom at night.
I understand. John, there's a very rare syndrome which is often brought on by stress, which occurs when two people's psyches become entwined. It's a shared disorder called folie à deux, when two people with close emotional ties share the same hallucination.
Hallucination?
There's no intruder, John. It's in your imagination and in Mia's.
What the fuck are you talking about?
John, I'd like you to look at this, please.
What is this?
There was no one there, John. Nobody else in the room but you and your daughter.
Mr. Farrell.
Who the fuck are you?
This is David Wharton from Social Services. We're all here to help you, John. The condition can be treated very successfully through therapy. But John, the first step will be to separate you from Mia for a while.
If you have nowhere else to go, we can help you out with that.
I recommend that you speak to my colleague, Dr. Nowinski. He said he'll treat you.
This is ridiculous. It doesn't make any sense. I was in the fucking room. He was there. He was attacking my daughter. Sue, you were there. Tell them. Sue.
Tell them!
Mr. Farrell. You need to calm down.
I didn't see anything. You saw the video. There's nobody there.
I don't fucking believe you. So you think I'm crazy, do you? Don't worry. By the time you get home.
you get home, Daddy's not gonna be there. We have to separate you for a little while.
Mum says you've been writing a story at school.
Who is Hollow Face?
Susanna, it might be easier for me if you left us alone for a minute. Mia, is there something you want to tell us? Did your father tell you the story? You know Hollow Face isn't real.
Again, Mrs. Farrell, please let us know immediately.
Yes, I will.
Maybe we can get a court order.
No, it won't be deemed necessary, seriously.
Okay.
So, this is the room.
It's a nice room, Mia.
Do you mind if we talk outside? Mia, I'm gonna be back in a minute, yeah? If we go for a nice yummy meal tonight. Yeah? Like a Chinese restaurant? What do you think? Good idea? Let's go.
Thank you.
Can I speak with you when you have a minute?
Dice que quiero hablar contigo.
Just be a nightmare. I'm sure you'll calm down.
Because someone called his name. After many, many years, he was free.
John?
He's back.
Who is back?
Tú sabes quién.
No sé de qué me estás hablando, hijo.
Sí lo sabes.
No. No puede ser.
Me dijiste que lo había inventado. Que lo había soñado. Me mentiste. It's all over now, because I know who he is, and I know why he came back.
Come on, keep talking, keep talking, keep talking.
Holoface woke up because someone called his name. After many, many years, he was free. He wasn't young or old. Ugly or handsome, he had no shame. He didn't even have a face. They had locked him away in a dark, tiny hole where the sun would shine.
He
Leatherface had to find the boy. He had to find his face. When he finally found where the boy was hiding, Leatherface didn't know what to do. Seeing the mother kiss the boy made him feel envious. He wanted to be like the boy. He wanted to be loved. So he devised a plan. First, they'd separate the boy from his mother. Then they'd bring him to his lair. And he would rip off his face and wear it himself.
I'll never come back again, I promise. It's over.
Face woke up because someone
your face wasn't old or young, ugly or handsome. He had no shape. He didn't even have a face. He had nothing.